You may think you are moving your arm by your control. It's not so. You can watch the brain real time. Moments before you decide to move your hand, the brain had decided to move the hand. It's only an illusion that you have decided to move your hand. Now the problem is, you are identifying yourself with your thoughts, with your mind, with your body, and the so-called self. This we call anatma, or anatma in Sanskrit, which means false identification. And why is there this false identification? Because of what we call in Sanskrit prajnaparada, or failure of intelligence, which is what we try to awaken in level 2. Because of failure of intelligence, you are having wrong identification, which leads to a sense of separation. The sense of separation is the cause of all problems. All problems inside yourself are caused because of this sense of separation. All problems in the family are caused because of the sense of separation. All problems in your country are caused because of the sense of separation. All problems in the world arise because of the sense of separation. If you remove the sense of separation, then there are no problems in the individual, no problems in the family, no problems in the nation, no problems in the world. That is the root cause of all problems. To be free of the self is the only revolution. Not the French Revolution, not the American Revolution, not the Russian Revolution, not the Chinese Revolution. Those revolutions were necessary. Yes, but they have their place. But that is not going to transform man. That is not going to end suffering. The only solution for all our problems is to ultimately awaken, where we lose this sense of separation. That is the real problem. So in the first part of the teachings for February, you will focus on the fact that your thoughts are not your thoughts, your mind is not your mind, your body is not your body, your self is only a concept. The next part of the teaching here is, all things are happening automatically. They're all happening automatically. That is, thinking is happening automatically. Not that you are thinking. There's nobody there, let us say, like Gearman. There's no Gearman who is thinking. No. There is simply thinking, that is all. Gearman has nothing to do with it. Thinking is simply happening. It is a function of the brain. When you become awakened, you see thinking is just happening. There's no thinker. Suppose you draw a circle, the center automatically comes up. Thinking is happening. It is automatically creating an illusion of the thinker. There is no thinker. Only thinking is happening. It's all automatic. Speech. You think you're speaking? No. Speech is happening automatically. Action is happening automatically. So all things are happening automatically. So this is what you've got to focus the month of February. That all things are happening automatically. It's only our illusion that there is a controller, that there's a thinker. There's a controller who's controlling all actions, that there's a thinker who is thinking. It's not so. It's all happening automatically. So you will try to understand this intellectually, you will contemplate on this, and you will meditate on this. This is the programming. It'll enter your mind. And there it will stay as an understanding or as an insight. And then when we go for the process, when we activate the kundalinis and we make the chakras rotate faster, all these teachings would integrate and would become a realization. When that happens, you will be pushed out of your mind. You will be detached from your mind. Your mind will be decluttered from you. And you will be watching your own mind. And the mind will be functioning automatically. Right now, you are living within the mind. All of you there, you are only existing. You are not living because you are living the life of the mind. You are in prison. The prison called mind. You are all prisoners within the prison called mind. And you do not even know you are in a prison. Because you are very intelligent, you have nicely organized all the furniture inside the prison. It is so nicely organized, you don't even feel bad being in the prison, except now and then. All the furniture are arranged. What is the furniture? Your attachment to your wife, husband or children, your attachment to money, your attachment to property, your attachment to name and fame, your attachment to excitement, this and that. This is the furniture. All this has been arranged, it is good. You must arrange it and we'll also help you with it. But then, that's only for survival. But then, that is not living. That is merely existing. You can start living only once you come out of the prison. Now this prison is locked from inside and outside. The inside lock, you must try to open. How will you open? You must realize you are living in a prison. Once you realize you are living in a prison, you would like to get out. Then you will open the lock inside. The outside lock you cannot open. The Diksha will blast open the outer lock and then you will come out of prison. When you come out of prison, you will see your mind is there, intact. All your knowledge is intact. But you are out of it. It will be working automatically and it will beautifully run your life. The problem is when you get involved. When you merely become a witness consciousness, the mind is automatically functioning. You can drive your car, drive the plane, you can do your work, you can be engineer, you can be doctor, you can do anything. Without any stress, very efficiently, the mind will be working. And you will be watching your mind working. When you come out of the mind, when you are free of the mind, you are awakened. Right now, the mind is like a huge donkey. Instead of it serving you, or you riding on the donkey, you are carrying the donkey on your shoulders. That is your condition. The mind is holding you prisoner. It is making use of your life for its survival. You are not at all free. You have been taken over as a prisoner. So only when you jump out of the mind, you are truly free. You would start living. You would then know what it is to live. Then all your questions of what is God, who is God, how did the universe begin? What is the purpose of life? What is the meaning of life? Everything disappears. Completely gone. Because the one who's asking these questions is gone. The questioner is gone. The questions are gone. There are no answers to these questions. The questioner must go. And that's what we're intending to do. So please, in the month of February, contemplate on what I've just now spoken. In the March, we'll be moving on to some other teachings. And then we go on like that in May and June, till we finally come to the process. In the process, all this will become your realization. And if you become awakened, you are free. So we shall now meditate for the next 3 minutes.